In the world of cars and trucks, most things have anywhere from 3 to 10 speeds on their transmission, whether it's an automatic or a manual, with most manuals falling between 5 to 7 gears, and most automatics falling between 4 and 10. And as time has gone on, as transmissions have gotten more advanced, we're seeing more and more gears for automatic transmissions specifically. So something like a ZF 8 speed is really common now in performance applications, and even something like a 10 speed in heavy duty applications such as the Ford 10 speed that you can get in the F-250, 350, and 450. But in the world of commercial trucks, things are much different. One, there's not nearly as many automatic transmissions, and two, the manual transmissions don't just have 5, 6, or 7 gears. Most of them have anywhere between 10 and 18 gears. So the question is, why? Why do they have so many gears, and what is the purpose of it? So right off the bat, I just want to get straight to the point and say that semi-trucks or commercial trucks, tractors, whatever you call them, they have a lot of gears, anywhere from 10 to 18 gears, for pretty much just two reasons. And that's torque multiplication and keeping the engine within its optimal power band. But as you see, as we go through the video, you'll see it's a little bit more complicated than just that. So starting this off, let's dive into the first reason for using a bunch of gears on a semi-truck. And that's because of the super narrow power band of these trucks. I won't go into crazy detail about why these trucks have narrow power bands, because we've covered a lot of that in our other video covering inline six engines and why semi-trucks use it, but to briefly cover some of it. With a low revving engine, there's reduced stress on basically everything, and it also helps to eliminate any complicated parts and allows the engine to be incredibly simple. Semi-truck engines generally make insane amounts of torque through a long stroke, as well as other design features. But with a super simple engine that's specifically designed to last upwards of 1 million miles or more, plus the long stroke, these engines generally have very low rev limiters, which also means they have a very narrow power band. With many commercial trucks, you're seeing peak power from, let's say, 600 to 1600 RPM, or 1000 to 1500 RPM. It's different for every truck depending on the engine, but simply put, there's typically only a couple hundred RPM of peak usable power and efficiency, so you need to keep the engine within that range. To stay in that range though, that means you need to have a lot of gears. Say for example, you only had a few hundred RPMs of usable power mated with a 3-speed transmission. By the time you shift from first to second, or second to third, you'll be putting the engine outside of its peak power band, which means you'll lose power, and probably lose speed. So, by using a transmission with upwards of 18 forward gears, you can constantly keep the engine in that narrow power band for improved acceleration and fuel efficiency. You also have to remember that with a lower engine operating speed comes reduced fuel consumption and improved emissions output. That brings me to the second point, which is torque multiplication. And for those that don't already know, let's take a quick look at an extreme theoretical example of torque multiplication of a lawnmower engine pulling a train. We only have a couple of horsepower to work with, and let's say that the train weighs 100,000 pounds, just to make this simple. If we hooked the engine to the train at a high gear ratio, let's say 1 to 1, for example, the engine would immediately die once it was loaded up, as it doesn't have the power to move something that heavy at that kind of gear ratio. But if we take it to the other extreme and use something like a 100 to 1 gear ratio, the engine won't stall once loaded up, and it will be able to move that heavy load. However, it will be incredibly slow. With that in mind, we can look at something like an Eaton 10-speed transmission, where we can see the first gear is listed at 14.8 to 1, then second at 10.95 to 1, then third at 8.09 to 1, and so on, until 10th gear at 1 to 1. With a lower gear ratio, like 14.8 to 1, the torque of the engine is multiplied before it reaches the wheels and gives the drive wheels effectively more torque than what the engine is actually outputting. But the downside to this is that the low gear ratio is very, very slow. In some applications, first gear can only get you to a couple of miles per hour, but that's really all you need. The hardest part of driving a commercial truck is getting it moving from 0 miles an hour. Once it's moving, it's easier and easier to keep it moving as you accelerate. As such, the gear ratio goes lower and lower and lower to decrease effective torque at the wheels while also increasing drive speed to allow the truck to get up to highway speeds. With that in mind, it's easy to understand why having more gears is better for an application like a semi-truck, because with more gears comes less difference in torque multiplication from one gear to another. What I mean by this is the percentage difference in torque multiplication between gears is reduced when you have more gears, which simply means you have more pulling power all the way until your final gear as compared to a transmission with less gears. And this also works in the other direction, where engine braking or Jake braking is very important on these trucks, as you generally want to use your actual brakes as little as possible, especially on a descent when loaded to reduce wear and tear on the truck and also prevent your brakes from overheating, which can cause them to fail entirely. By having more gears to pick from, you can effectively engine brake harder as compared to a transmission with less gears. And really, this is just torque multiplication in reverse, where first gear and last gear will have the same engine braking strength on something like a 10-speed versus an 18-speed, assuming that the first and the last gear have the same ratios. But all the gears between will offer better engine braking on the 18-speed because of the reduced percentage change in gear ratio from one gear to another. And before we move on to the next section, I'd like to mention that as a truck is set up for longer and heavier loads, you'll generally find more gears on it. It's not always the case, but typically the long, heavy load pulling trucks are going to have the 18-speed, where something like a day cab truck might have a 10-speed. There's a clear trend towards using an 18-speed for the longer distance loads, but it's not always the case. So what about other drivetrains? Well, with torque multiplication and the narrow power band in mind, why not just use a transmission that keeps the engine in the correct power band at all times, such as a continuously variable transmission? And the answer to that is actually pretty simple, and that's reliability. While technically a properly designed CVT could work on a semi-truck, there's nothing out there that currently fills that gap. There have been developments towards a semi-truck CVT transmission, but the big thing holding it back is reliability. These trucks make a decent amount of power, and they have to haul very, very heavy loads, which means the actual load on the drivetrain is insanely high, and a CVT would likely end up burning up from the sheer load on the drivetrain. That being said, CVTs have been used in heavy-duty applications plenty of times before. You can find them in tanks, tractors, and so on. But for a truck that needs to reliably haul upwards of 100,000-pound loads all across the US, or whatever country you live in, a CVT is generally not going to give the driver the reliability that they're looking for. With that in mind, though, there is another option which has been gaining popularity, which is the automatic transmission. Historically, these weren't used because they simply couldn't handle the drivetrain loads while also delivering excellent reliability. But in recent years, that's beginning to change. For example, the Kenworth T680 is one of the trucks that are now available with an automatic transmission. Some of the automatic transmissions on the market work simply as an automated manual transmission that shifts gears and actuates the clutch automatically. And some of them are actually designed as a true automatic transmission from the ground up. It really just depends on the application. Understandably, the auto transmission is picking up in popularity quite a lot, as it makes the trucks much easier to drive, which then opens the doors to more drivers and pretty much completely eliminates the injuries that can happen to long-term over-the-road truck drivers, such as their rotator cuff and their shoulder getting messed up from shifting so often every single drive for years or decades on end. So that's the quick explanation about why semi-trucks, commercial trucks, tractors, whatever you call it, why they have so many gears. And it's pretty much just to keep the engine in the optimal power band, which also means more power and more fuel efficiency and reduced emissions output, but also torque multiplication, because with those shorter gears, you can get a heavier load moving. So in first gear, if it's a really, really low gear, you can get the load moving. And then as you go up, it gets easier and easier and easier. So something like a 3-speed versus an 18-speed, if the first gear and the last gear are effectively the same gear ratio, the 18-speed is going to have a much easier time pulling all the way up until its final drive speed because it has so many more gears in between and because the difference in gear ratio between each gear is reduced as compared to something like a 3-speed. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to smash the thumbs up button, get subscribed so you don't miss out on future videos, check out some of the other stuff on the channel, and I'll see you guys in the next one.